Hello everyone, Kiki here. I am playing a special game. You can play it on Facebook, but I got it mostly for my phone. So I was like, okay, let me play at least a episode or do a guy chapter. Like, I did most of them, most of the guys. We're changing. There's two Makotos, which in my other one, I'm already doing Makoto. I already did Toru. I didn't do Shintaro or Kagura. Asagi, Yoko, Ritsu, Edward, and Yuzuki. Anyway, when I first played this, I was going to go in order, like doing Yuzuki, which I did first, then I did Edward's, then I did Ritsu's. And for some reason, I had two phones, so I did one with Makoto, and then once I was done with Ritsu on my other phone, I did Toru's, and so, which I finished Toru's. Once I finished Toru's, I was like, okay, I'm gonna do Yuko, which I just finished like 5 minutes ago. So I'm going to do Asagi. I think that's how you pronounce his name. And so we're gonna do a story with him and see how well you guys like it. This is called Shall We Date? Ninja Shadow. You can find it on Facebook. I hope you guys like it. I do personally. So let's see what's his personality is. His favorite style is cool. He likes animals, dislikes waking up early, hobby dance, skill, swordplay and sorcery, and boss, Matoto Nakagawa. He would not reveal his true feelings. A mature man who's skillfully avoids others, roasts in the flame of prediction. That's a little bit of saggy. We don't need to look at the preview, so that's what we're doing. We're starting a new one. So, new story. So, Asagi main story, chapter one. Oh yeah, since I already start this already, before the story starts plays, the pre thing, this is where you get to choose your partner. But before, let me recap. You are this little girl and or young woman, and you have a twin, and there's this bad guy who killed your twin brother, and you tried to be his doppelganger because, you know, the two of you are, you know, twins, and you tried to look up your brother, try to avenge him, try to fill in the role because right before the brother died, you and the brother were going to go to Nagis, or the city that she's in now, and try to earn a way to, let's see, help build the hometown you and your brother lived in. And so I hope that kind of makes sense. So you're trying to play off your brother, trying to avenge your brother, and everyone that you partner up with will learn that you're not a man anymore. You're not really a man, actually. That you're actually a woman. You're trying to revenge your brother and yada yada yada, while falling in love with him. So that's the recap of it. So let's get into this. Like I said before, I picked Asagi so we can see what Asagi goes through. Okay. I named my character Kikyobarami, well, of course, and the brother, of course, would be Shino, of course. Anyway, alright, I would like to have Asagi as my instructor. I looked over at Asagi and noticed a slight hint of surprise had crossed his face. However, he immediately snapped back into attention. After that, he called out to me with a tone of wonder in his voice. "Shino, why did you choose me?" "Why? It's not like I could tell him that basically I chose him at random." Unable to explain my reasoning, I found myself lo at loss of words. "There are plenty of people more qualified to be your instructor than me," Asagi said. "Like, take Yukio, for example. He's really supportive and really looks after everyone. And Yuzuki, he is the friendly guy I know." Asagi vaguely tried to talk up the other members of the vigilante as he looked back at them. I skipped a little bit because I was fixing my phone. Mayoko says Asagi has been the Nagasaki village longer than anyone else. Shino, I am positive that you'll learn a lot from him. Make sure you're not to cause Saki too much trouble. All right. Makoto, with his voice of authority, decided that Asaki would be my instructor. In this suffocating, tense atmosphere, Asaki grunts with displeasure. Clearly, he does not like to be with someone anyway. There's no reason to look that upset. If he didn't want to be my instructor so badly, he would have said, flat out refuse. He looked like I held a knife to his throat and forced him to be my instructor. Oh, yeah. Even though I was the one who chose Asaki as my instructor, I had already begun regretting it. Asaki was now silently giving me a dirty look. Tension between was now painful, obvious. Makoto says, now that we have decided upon what to do with Shino, I would like to talk about our next mission. Given the fact, like I told you guys, your character is playing the role of your brother, so you're gonna be having a different name. So, they don't know that for sure. No one knows that you're a woman. No one knows that you're trying to pretend your brother of your brother until someone says, I know that you are your brother trying to pretend that he is. So that's what it is. I couldn't tell whether or not Makoto noticed the tension between us, but he continued to explain our next mission in an indifferent manner. Our target is the psychotic murderer on a killing spree. He is the son of Hatamoto Samurai under the Shogun Shogunate, said Matoto. Due to Hamato's powerful position, the townspeople are helpless. Therefore, everyone silently looked as the other way as Hatamoto continues to his killing spree. Mako glanced over at Yuko. Yukio is investigating into the matter. As a commissioner, he periodically receives petitions in regards of this matter. Yukio nodded in agreement across his arms. Yukio says he somehow got his hands on a pretty high-end sword, so he's been testing it out on people of Nagasaki at random. It's hard to describe how sick these murders has been. Let's just say this guy is out of his mind. I get loads of petitions in the like after on after when one of these murders. I can't speak today. Clearly. He let a power get to him. It's something that has. Let me say that. He let the power get to him. It's something that the average person couldn't even dream about. Jesus Christ, I can't speak today. After shrugging his shoulder in detached manner, Yukio continued to give us a rundown of the situation. Shintaro suddenly leaned in forward to and cut off Yukio off. This makes me sick. How could anyone get so drunk off of power? He is the disgrace of all men who live by this sword, or by the sword. How dare he use the power that he has for evil, such as the head of the dojo and teacher of the martial arts himself? I cannot allow this to go on any longer. My lord, please leave me to this matter to me. Awfully furious, Shitaro edged in closer to Miyako. However, Makoto calmly looked back at Shintaro and shook his head. When it comes to our vigilante missions, people who let their emotions get the best of them are unable to make a level-headed decision, which leads to failure. Do you understand what I'm getting out, Shintaro? You should be the last person I should ask to participate in this mission. Next. But my lord, I would like to leave this mission in the hands of Shino and Asagi. I want this to be Shino's first mission as a vigilante. The moment Makoto had clearly made up his mind, a look of dissatisfaction flashed through the faces of Shintaro and Asagi. I'll be able to take care of the target myself. Asagi, the purpose of this mission is for you to lead and give instruction to Shino. I need you both working together on this. But Makoto, this is an order. I can't wait. With an unexchanging expression, Makoto flat out told Asagi how things were to be or going to be. Asagi let out a sigh as if he knew nothing that would change, no matter how much he argued. Shino, don't get in my way. Jesus Christ. Know I'm new, but and I know I may be a dead weight. However, he didn't even put it so bluntly like that. I know I'm a little late. I almost want to ask if I can change my structure. Gagura, you will assist as Asagi and Shino in on their mission. Yes, my lord. Oh, Kagura. I can say Kagura correctly because I used to watch Naruto. So, Kagura brief said as he nodded. Makoto's. Yukio Edward. Ed. Hard. Oh, I'm gonna say Edward because it's a mental thing. But I know it's pronounced different because of the U. And Yuzuki have their hands full with other missions as of now. Shintaro, I want you to help Yuzuki with on his mission. But Shinto, this is an order. You're going to have to no part in the Hatamoto mission. See, after seeing Makoto said that in such a indifferent tone, Shintaro bit off his lip and fell into silence. Now that everyone's role has been decided upon, you may now go and do not disappoint me. The room was overwhelmed in awkward silence the moment Makoto ended the meeting. I must be going now, said Shintaro. Shintaro was the first one to get up and to leave. After he walked out the room, with a long stride in a upset manner. So Sasuke gave a bow to us and rushed and followed closely behind Shintaro. Asagi also got up and turned on his heels in order to go somewhere else as well. I was lost at words what I should do. Asagi! All of a sudden, Matoto called out to Asagi to stop him. Asagi glared back at Matoto as he were somewhat annoyed. "What?" Asagi said. "Makoto says the mission is to be carried out tomorrow night. Before the mission, I would like you to introduce Shino to the head of Himaru Shrine." "All right," said Asagi. Asagi half-heartedly nodded and looked back at me in an annoyed manner. So, this is the type of stuff that has been, is, it's difficult. So, I'm gonna be reading mostly when people are talking. So, stop dawdling or going, Asaki said. Do I get work up over it or get ready to leave? Let's get ready. Sorry, it looks like I need to hurry. Makoto, thank you so much. I bowed to Makoto and rushed off to the room so I won't lose sight of Asagi. Asagi saw how I was acting and let out a sigh as if he was bored of me already. "Shino, you're not the sharpest tool in the shed, are you?" Asagi said. "Why are you getting that?" "How should I put this? Put it? I guess we'll just say you're not very optimistic." I was trying to say that I don't really get along with people like you. I could tell that Asaki was being sarcastic with me now. I looked down at the ground as I bit my lip. "I was just have to deal with it and put up with this. I need to do this for my brother and my village. I am the one who chose this guy after all." Asaki's lips faintly curled upward as he saw my reaction. With a smirk on his face, he made his way out of the room. I picked up the pace, followed closely behind him so I wouldn't be left behind. Asagi walked throughout the Miko Salon at a quick pace. Surprisingly, he carried himself very well and didn't make too much of a noise as he walked around. But now was not the time to be observing his behavior. Asagi was much taller than me, so his long stride made it hard for me to keep up. "Asagi, where are we going?" "You'll know when we get there," Asagi said. Saki had given me these ambiguous non-answers ever since the meeting had ended. The distance between us only grew due to lack of concentration on his part. Consideration. I'm sorry. Sorry. Oh, I'm trying to read. I'm losing sight of Asaki at this rate. Thereupon, I made my mind to dash after him. Right at that moment, Asaki suddenly stopped in the place and turned around. What are you walking so slow for? What are you, a girl or something? His words were full of ridicule. I could feel my face begin to burn with rage and impatience. Asaki widely scrolled over where I was standing, got up in my face, and stared at right at me. You're angry. Then show me what you're made of and prove yourself to me, Saki said. What does the length of my stride have to do with my ability as a vigilante? Said my character said. As if he keeps staring at me closely, he's going to figure out I'm really a girl. I took a step back in order to get out of his line of sight. However, Asaki closed the distance between us once more and looked of disbelief on his face. Wow, you really do look like a woman. I felt like I'm being backed into a corner. Every time I look a step back, Asaki took a step forward. Happened right when Asaki had opened his mouth to say something. I didn't realize that the floor behind me was uneven, so I tripped over and fell. Oh, Jesus Christ. Two more chapters, and I won't have any more tickets until in a few hours. So, like I said, this is a game. So, here we go. So, this is. Oop. Is that all I have left? That. A little bit. Let's see. 73. Okay. So I got 7 red tickets. Every 4 hours you get new tickets to read, so so you get your wardrobe, his wardrobe, your accessories, his accessories, and other. So. Like some of the prizes are some of his clothes. Backgrounds and jades. Some of your hair, some of the other stuff. I would like to get more of these dresses here and shoes and hopefully get more of these down here. So, if I do that, I got none of those. And so this headband. Since I got a lot of the same stuff. Sell most of it. There was something for So, actually, I'm going to end it there, and it will give me some time to regain energy or power to get to 70, to 100, and we can continue because we're at, we had the talent and skill check mark. So, I mean, like, I could raise it with Jade, but it'd be easier just to wait a little bit just to actually gain up to 100 right now. So, I'm going to wait and to gain some energy left, and go from there. And hopefully we will get through this story. I really hope you guys like this. I'm trying to keep this as much as professional as I can. Yeah, it's going to be on Facebook, and yeah, it's, people are going to see that I'm on and want to talk to me, and I will try to limit as much as I can on that. I think I can. Probably turn that off. So, I hope you guys like. I hope you guys enjoy. I'll see you guys another time. Bye!